This is the biggest breakthrough is when Google first created Google.
Can you explain what internet is?
It is called Google.
At Google, our mission is to make the world's information accessible and useful.
Or when Apple created the iPhone.
Every once in a while, a revolutionary product comes along that changes everything. And we are calling it iPhone.
Some of these people have been here for days. People are pretty enthusiastic.
I'm talking about chatbots.
Tonight we're taking a closer look at a new technology that's making waves in the world of AI,
ChatGPT. It's a chatbot that runs on artificial intelligence, and it can do pretty much anything you tell it to do from—
This is— And it knows to cache it, so it's not created every single time. I am— Oh my God.
Okay, it's like actually talking. If we remove the L horizontal and use the box component, how does it know about the box component?
It's a new kind of chatbot that will write essays for you, write your cover letters for you, explain tricky math problems, or write complex essays for you. ChatGPT is the first, and Microsoft loves it. It's investing billions of dollars into ChatGPT. And now Google is creating its own version of this called Bard. In fact, Google was so afraid of ChatGPT taking over as the world's go-to search engine, it issued a code red. Yes, it was actually called a code red. It was this internal initiative for staff and engineers to figure out an action plan so it doesn't become obsolete. As a writer and vlogger and journalist and creator, this is actually kind of exciting to me because I can see it as something that can help me to write scripts and make research easier. Some see it as an opportunity, but others see it as a threat. I met a 56-year-old journalist at CES, the world's biggest tech conference.
I had nightmare during Christmas after testing it because it made articles. I'm 56 years old. I've been a journalist for 37 years. It really scared me. Now I'm trying to learn everything about it.
See, she is afraid that ChatGPT will literally steal her job.
I don't believe these things can do the articles that I can do.
And then there are other industries like software developers. The average software developer makes $121,000 per year. They're not cheap, and companies need a lot of them.
And how much do you make at your full-time job?
I make roughly 100K.
So around the 200K ballpark.
But what if there are these free tools that can do similar stuff? Will their jobs be in jeopardy? I asked a bunch of software developers what they think about ChatGPT. Here's what they said.
Software developers, should they be worried about AI?
People who just write React components, yes. People who solve problems, no.
Citizen coder jobs might be in jeopardy, where you just go to a boot camp and like you do something very quick. I think real software engineers who actually study the field won't be in danger.
Maybe, but I think software engineers, there's always like another thing coming.
I'm a software engineer by trade. I love coding. I think that it will be a helpful tool. Maybe I would do more architecture, write some core pieces, oversee what the AI do.
There's going to be software engineers that develop new AI.
For software engineers, no, I think it's great for them. I mean, you know, you have a bug in your code, just put it in ChatGPT and ask it to fix it. It'll really help software people. I think lawyers are the people who might be a little bit in trouble.
At the root of this technology is something that actually isn't that new. You've been hearing about this for a while now. I'm talking about AI.
Good morning, Anna.
Nice to meet you again, Jack.
I'm sure you've heard of ChatGPT. It's the AI chatbot.
Tell Lewis I'm busy, but we can chat next week. And it will create me a response to that week. Bam. And then I can click that and it adds it into the email. Paint over this plane. Bam. Let the AI do the magic, and the AI literally made it disappear.
Artificial intelligence. It means that machines are being developed to do tasks that normally only people could do. There are now AI machines that can play chess, drive cars, and even deliver the news. So naturally, we understand why AI is threatening our jobs. But hold on. See, this isn't exactly a new concern. Throughout history, people have worried that new technologies would make their jobs disappear. But what's actually happened is that new technologies have created new jobs that didn't even exist before. When the car was invented, people were worried that horses and buggy drivers would lose their jobs. But what actually happened is new jobs were created for car mechanics and automobile manufacturers. It used to take 50% of the population to feed the other 50% of the population. And today, less than 1% of Americans are actually farmers, because technological innovations have made farming easier than ever. In Iceland, one, I met a farmer that literally has robotic machinery milking the cows. This is an early 20-something who manages like 30 cows all by himself, and he uses an app to track the health and productivity of each cow. And if a cow tries to get milked too many times in one day, the machines won't let it enter. This guy tells me that he's an exception to other people his age. See, most people his age don't want to work on a farm. So in a way, you can argue that technology like this is not a nice to have, it's a must have to prevent a food and farming shortage. Then there is Amazon, that's opening up so many stores that completely eliminate the cashier. I've been to their grocery stores, their convenience stores, and now they're even partnering with Starbucks to make a cashierless experience. My point here is that technology is a good thing. And it's always threatened to steal jobs. But history has proven that that's usually a good thing.
Larry, should we be afraid of Google?
Wow, he just cut right to the chase.
But the question is this, will this time be different? Well, it's true that AI has the potential to automate certain tasks that were previously done by people, but it's also true that AI will create new jobs we can't even imagine yet. As AI machines get better at doing tasks, they will need people to design, build, and maintain them. They'll also need people to develop the algorithms and programs that control how the machines work. Okay, but what about the people that are doing the jobs that AI is now going to automate, like, let's say, factory workers? Yes, some, if not many, people will have to find new jobs. But it's also true that AI has the potential to make our lives better in many ways. Like, if AI machines are doing tasks that are dangerous or unpleasant, then people will be freed up to do more interesting and fulfilling work. So what can we do to prepare for a future that's dominated by AI? Well, the most important thing is to become a lifelong learner. What we learned in university is not going to serve us in 10, 20, 30 years from now. The jobs of the future are going to require different skills than the jobs of the past. So we're now going to have to constantly adapt. And I'm not just talking about every 5 years, I mean, every few months. And jobs in computer programming, data analysis, and digital design are going to be in high demand in the future. There's also another scenario that might play out as soon as in the next decade, which is universal basic income. This is the concept where governments are exploring that maybe there are not enough jobs to go around. Maybe everything will just be automated by AI and robots and computers, that we will actually have to pay citizens just to live, a monthly income, a monthly salary, to just live and breathe.
Everyone can be rich?
Everyone can be rich.
Everyone.
Imagine if tomorrow we could wave a wand and everybody was trained as a scientist or an engineer. Everybody. Even if you weren't very good, you had enough understanding of computers, you could write some code, you could build some hardware. Now, if they're educated all as hardware, software, engineers, scientists, biologists, technicians, hard sciences, not the social sciences, we would all be done within 5 years. Robots would be doing everything from cleaning toilets to cooking food to flying airplanes to driving Ubers.
Another thing we all have to keep in mind is to stay curious and keep learning. Think outside the box, because the jobs of the future will actually require people who think creatively and solve problems in new and innovative ways.
And what would we be doing? We would be doing all creative jobs to entertain each other and researching science and technology. We would have wonderful lives. So it is really just a question of education, nothing else.
AI is not gonna steal our jobs, but it is gonna change them. But as long as we stay flexible, curious, and adaptive, I think we'll be able to thrive in this new world. And whether I wrote this script or ChatGPT wrote this script, well, I guess you'll never know.
Okay, so what I just said, what I just read to you, I didn't write that, and my staff didn't write that either. No human wrote it. That was written by a new online tool called ChatGPT.